Hi everybody, Raj here. I'm the president of Contact Center World and I'm going to be your host for this short presentation on how to celebrate International Contact Center Week. First things first though, switch off the phone. Don't want to get disturbed as we talk about this really important week for our industry. So here's what we're going to cover. We're going to talk about why celebrate our industry week, how to celebrate, some ideas from past participants, and we're also going to talk about the new age of working from home. We're also going to give you some top tips for a successful event. But let's start off, why celebrate our industry event? Well, I've been involved in the contact center industry for many years, and when I set up Contact Center World in 1999, I realized, like everybody else, there are certain national days and certain industry weeks. Like every year, there's a customer service week. But hey, some of us don't work in customer services alone. We work in sales, in marketing. We work in, you know, telemarketing industry. So back in 2008, what we decided to do was to launch a special industry week just for you, me, and the millions of other people who work in contact centers. It doesn't matter whether you're in sales, customer service, support, help desk, it doesn't really matter. This is our week. So we launched International Contact Center Week. We launched it, and every year it's been really successful. We have hundreds of and thousands of contact centers all around the world participating. So, okay, why celebrate it? Well, there's a few good reasons why we want to celebrate our industry. It is our industry week, okay? We're not jumping on the back of someone else's week, like a customer service week. Customer service week may have been around for many years, even before contact centers existed. So why do we want to just join those? We want our own week. Celebrating is fun. We work in a very demanding industry. Contact centers are not easy places to work at the best of times. Okay, we want to make them fun. We're always trying to think of new fun ideas that we can do in our contact center to make it fun for our team, because it's hugely motivational. And having a week dedicated to contact centers tells all your contact center teams and your people, hey, we're in a big industry. We're not just some small contact center taking calls or fielding complaints. We're part of a big global industry, so it's hugely motivational. And it can help team building, and also we can use it to help the community. I'm going to start off by playing a very short video from Australia. And this was a company that you've probably heard of called Siemens, and they're going to tell you a little bit about what they, or how they benefited and why they got involved.
One of the many initiatives Steve McKenzie, our Siemens Customer Care Center Manager, brought back from last year's Contact Center World Conference was that we should hold an International Contact Center Week, which we did in September. Actually, it was probably the event that showed us what we can do with our department. It's really what started our social events. It really helped with our teamwork. It actually is one of the things that brought about our charity program, which is also running very successfully. We had two different events on each day. We had things like trivia, which we sent through email, and internet scavenger hunt. We had bin basketball. We had golf. We had hat day. We had silly sock day. We had the final day culminated in a bring a plate lunch where everybody was asked to prepare a dish or the dessert or savory, and we all shared it together. So it really brought us together as a team. We had a lot of fun while still maintaining our excellent customer service standards. And we plan to run it again this year because it was very successful.
Thank you, Melissa. Now, the world has changed though, okay? We recognize most organizations don't have centralized contact centers. Many of us are working from home, so we've got to consider work from home ideas as well as stuff that you can do in a contact center. So we've got some ideas for you. We've cherry picked some based on what participants have done in past years, and these can apply to you when you've got a work from home model, or as well as if you come to the office. So first one, from Ukraine. One of our members out there, an outsource company, they have this program during International Contact Center Week, which was best designed slippers. Simple idea. We all got slippers, dress them up. Come on in, maybe have some prizes. You can do that from home or in the center. Then there's from Denmark, Crazy Hat Day. Another one of our members, what they did is they got everybody to just design a hat. It doesn't matter. It can be based on any theme. Even if it's in September, this one's got a a Christmassy type theme. Doesn't matter if you don't have a hat, beg, borrow, or steal one from somebody in your household, or make one up. Again, you can have some prizes. Now, in the contact center space, we're using headsets. Okay, I haven't got mine on today, but we all use headsets. So dress up your headset day. Again, very, very successful, very simple, a lot of fun. People like doing it. Just be careful that you don't actually block the microphones and you can still have those conversations. But it's a lot of fun and people love having their photos. Get some selfies, put them on Instagram, share what you're doing. Another company in Malaysia this time, they did a similar thing. They actually gave out some prizes when they celebrated International Contact Center Week. And they were one of the first to celebrate many, many years ago. Then if you look at Australia, here's another company out there. What they did is they did a bake a cake. So invite all your staff to maybe make a cake for International Contact Center Week. Doesn't matter what it looks like, doesn't matter what it tastes like. It's a lot of fun. You can do it from home. Just get your team to get whatever ingredients they can to put something together. Going to United States, I'm going to show you a short video from one of the companies over in the States and what they did. Okay, that phone shutdown wasn't my idea. I'm not sure what their plan was, but that's how they celebrated International Contact Center Week. Now let's go to some other parts of the world. Let's go to Fiji. This is a company. What they did during International Contact Center Week is they invited all their staff to think of all their funny stories, their hilarious phone conversations they've had with people, and to recount them and actually give some prizes out for funny stories. Really simple idea. While we're in Asia, let's head over to Japan and see what one of the securities and investment companies did during International Contact Center Week. Okay, just a little fun video they put together for us to share with you. Australia, here's a really good idea, Crazy Sock Day. Doesn't matter if you've got mismatched socks, crazy socks, weird socks, I've got socks with elephants on, doesn't matter. Maybe have a Crazy Sock Day in your contact center. Now let's spring over to Portugal and see what one of the big companies in Portugal did to celebrate International Contact Center Week. So as you can see, it's all about just having fun in your contact center, whether you're working from home or in a centralized center. Now let's give you some other fun ideas, okay? And we're gonna have loads of these on our website for you. But there's a backwards there. You can get your staff to dress up for the best or worst dressed person. Could be just dress up backwards, put all your clothes on back to front. Another simple idea, how well do you know your coworkers or your boss? This is actually a really good one to, you know, ask questions and get to know how well your boss, how well you know your boss. Then there's other things like company trivia. This is a good one because you're talking about company products and services. See how much your teams know. Have some fun trivia competitions. This one always gets a laugh. Belly dance competition. Funniest and best dressed belly dancer. Okay, we can all have a go. We all got webcams. Just do something for fun. Then there's sports top days. Okay, we all probably have in our cupboard somewhere. Some of us are more active than others, but we all have like a sports team shirt or something. Wear it. Have some photos. Just dress up. Then there's silly souvenirs. Get your team to hunt around in their house for those silly little souvenirs they bought when they were on holiday or vacation. And talk about them. Say, hey, this is what I got. I bought it when I went to this place. Get people talking about stuff. It's fun. Bring your pet to work day. Okay, they're probably already with you. This is one of my dogs, Toby. He often comes in my office when I'm at work and just sits down with me, just lies down. Sometimes he falls asleep. Sometimes he makes funny noises when he's asleep, but I bring him to work, okay? So get your teams to bring your pet to work. Or if they don't have a pet, maybe get them to bring a toy, put it in front of them and just talk about it. What about asking people to share a crazy story, something they did when they were a kid? Something maybe a little bit naughty, but we all do as kids. We all have those little stories, okay? Things that we did, we can share. Nothing bad, just fun, naughty stuff, okay? That we all do when we're kids and people will laugh about it. There's stretch at your desk. Get people to maybe come up with some simple stretches, just things you can do when you're at your desk, whether you're in the home or working in a centralized office. Then there's other things, like you can take abstract photos of objects in your house, really weird angles, and then say, have a competition, see if people can guess what they are. Or get people to come up with a line from a movie and say, okay, let's see who can guess what this movie is, and have some prizes. Whatever you do, it's all about just having fun and making this a successful week. So here's some tips for you. Okay, get our ideas. We're going to have an online agenda published shortly on our website. We have loads of ideas and we'll even break it down into suggested itineraries. So we'll say, like on the first day, here's three or four things you could do. On the second day, here's three or four things you can do. But it's entirely up to you, okay? Whatever you want to do, you want to keep it fun. It's all about having fun in your contact center and showing everybody they're part of a big industry and it's motivational. But it also, don't forget, invite your staff to come up with some suggestions. Say, hey, we're going to be part of International Contact Center Week. What do you guys want to do? What do you guys want to have some fun? Come up with some ideas and let people develop those ideas. It's all team building. Tell everybody you're getting involved, okay? Don't just keep it to your contact center team. Tell everybody in the company. Post it on social media. We've got some banners that you can post as well. Share with everybody. Hey, we're going to celebrate our industry. We're really proud working in contact centers for our company. We're really proud being part of a global industry. And we have a lot of fun. And we're really proud to celebrate our industry week. Look to support some charities in the process, okay? Maybe look at ideas that you can build in where you can generate some money, or you can donate items. Maybe part of it is you just have let's all rummage through a house and pack a bag or a box of stuff we can donate to charity. So that could be one of the activities, but whatever you want to do, make sure you also think about people. It could be people in your company as well, who may be a little bit worse off because of the pandemic, or it could be other people in your community. But just try and think of things that you could do where you're also making some contribution to charities. Post a schedule. When you've got your plan for your week, and I know we're still a while out from the event, but when you get to getting really close, post the schedule so everybody knows what to do on what days they're dressing up, what days they're doing a crazy hat day, what days they're doing this, what days they're doing that. Post it on your intranet so everybody knows. Have some fun prizes. It's always nice if you can just have some little fun competitions and have some fun prizes. Could be silly prizes, or it could be like you get an hour off work on a Friday, you get to finish a bit early, so you don't have, you know, so they can go and celebrate. But also recognize your staff's achievements. Look, use it as an opportunity to recognize great work from people. It could be that you know, at the end of the week, you just have an internal competition and you announce all the winners, and you also just say thank you to everybody who's contributed towards the success of your contact center, especially during these difficult times. Recognition goes a long way, so make sure you recognize people. And record some activities and share them with us, just like we shared some videos with you. Even if people working from home or you've got a Zoom call, record it, share it with us about all the fun stuff you're doing. We all want to know what other people are doing these days. Share it with us, share it with your teams, and let's just post it for next year's event. I'm going to leave you with a parting video, and I will stay around for some questions if you have any, but let's just go to New Zealand.
Hey everyone here at Dammit Success New Zealand, we wish you all a happy International Contact Centre Week.
Okay, listen guys, this is your week. Enjoy it, have fun, celebrate our industry. Let's make it an awesome week. And don't just do it this year, but every single year, okay? It's our week, it's our own week. Let's own it, let's live it, let's celebrate it. Thank you, I'm gonna stay online for a few more minutes. I'm gonna switch off my camera, but I will be around if you've got any questions.